Yeah, so?
It stinks in here. I gotta wash this whole room.
Are you kidding? Wash it.
Let's wash it with Febreze.
For all the things you can't wash, use Febreze Fabric Refresher.
Whoa. Hey, Mrs. Weber. Hey, it smells nice in here.
And try pluggable Febreze to continuously eliminate odors for up to 45 days of freshness. Pluggable Febreze Fabric Refresher. Two more ways to breathe that moisture.
Draw that ball, you gotta follow.
My heart doesn't see race. Love is love. Come when you're out there.
His wife that just walked up. John's one of the top trainers here in Cross Energy Supercross, and Jorge actually comes over to the States to train with John. So interesting to see that even the top motorcycle road racers in the world like the way these Supercross guys train. Let's go back downstairs again.
Week in a row, Ryan Dungey is chasing a
perfect
night. He got fastest to qualify. He already won if he raced now. The whole shot and winning the main is up next. So I wanted to find out from the boss, Red Bull KTM team manager Roger DeCoster, what he had to say about Ryan Dungey. What he told me is that Ryan has always had that racing IQ, a toughness to him. But you add in his dedication to training. He doesn't take a day off. That is a perfect formula. And right now, it's hard to
is to grab the hole shot, and Marcia started out with the first hole shot. Since then, it's been Millsap, Brayton, and Dutch with the hole shots. Three KTMs in a row with hole shots.
KTM bringing you the Spider Cam as we pull back away from this Monster Energy Supercross. Juliana Daniel with the 32nd board. Remember, Dungey set quick time earlier today. One is his. If he wins the main, another perfect night. Don't forget, next week, we're in San Diego, Petco Park. You'll see it live.
Well, Dungey has led 56% of the laps here this year. The only rider that's been on the podium. He seems to be unstoppable. Can anyone stop Ryan and Chandler here tonight in Phoenix?
Continue
on with the win streak. He's going to have to go past what I think is the best guys. You got Ronson, Millsaps, Tomac, Steely, Reed in front of him. Still has Alessi in front of him. Done the whole panic, though. He'll work his way through. He'll take what's given to him.
List.
You put up one post, and the next day you have all these candidates.
It makes my job a lot easier.
Over 400,000 businesses have already used ZipRecruiter, and now you can use ZipRecruiter for free. Go to ZipRecruiter.com/offer55.
Systems tell us after a break has occurred. So I thought, what if you could prevent burglaries before they happen? My invention, the Ring Video Doorbell, does that.
Hello?
I'm doing free tree trimming estimates.
I'm dating the children right now.
With Ring, you're always home. Ring lets you see and speak whoever's at your home from anywhere. And with dual power options, you can install Ring in just minutes. Available at ring.com and these fine retailers. Ended up fourth, Celia, Reed, and the sixth. Listed Pike
back there at 11.
Names was there.
Rest of the top 22, Michael Essie was 12 or so. So trying to get it going in the main events. Pretty quick in his heat race, he's struggling in the mains. We go back to Jenny.
Was a little bit
unlike
you. Back, eighth, I think, was the farthest
back
you fell, but you worked your way back up to second. What's really driving you at this point to continue pushing? It looks like you were trying to get back up top then, too, race.
Oh, I was pushing it. You know, I didn't, that start wasn't the greatest. And the start, you got to be there. You know, you saw Ken get up front, he started to go, and that's where it's at. But, yeah, I tried to make the passes happen as quick as I could. I could make them clean and stick, and a couple close ones, but to get to the front and try to see if get myself a, chance at the end for maybe a win, but hey, second place, not bad, and can't win them all, but hey, you know, second place, we'll keep moving, and regardless, you know, Team Red Bull KTM, the 452, good night, gotta thank everybody. So track was tough, it's very fast, slippery, had to get your tires to the ground, so we're working tonight, so we'll keep building from here.
Ralph? 21st consecutive podium for Ryan Dungey. And look at the points here. Now, Roxton moved up two spots. Anderson dropped one. Reed dropped one. Tomac came up a spot. 5-17 in the books, Jay.
Eli, it's nice to see you back up on the podium. I know this year you've been working towards it, so third place finish tonight. It's been a little bit of a progress for you adjusting to the new Kawasaki. How has it been for you, and what's worked to get to this point?
That's right. You got to be kidding me.
It's just, it's been a little bit of a tough start, like you said. I mean, you know, you want to win, and you want to be up here as much as you can, but you got to be realistic. And I had a big off time, you know, with the injury and obviously transitioning to the new team. But there's been times where I felt like I had this podium speed, but it's never put it together in the main, and this time I was able to get out there early.
Too fancy.
And the front row with the lead guys. So that was a nice change of pace. Just couldn't quite put it all together at the end, but did what I could. And shoot, just thanks to all the Kawasaki guys at Monster Energy and Alpine Stars. You know, we definitely made improvements this week, during the week coming into this round, and it paid off.
There's a look at those podium shots, and everybody's celebrating as this one comes to a close here for the first time. University of Phoenix Stadium, and boy, what a great game.
It was. The track was spectacular. It was very difficult. Christian Craig went with amazing.
Christian Craig takes the win in the 250 West Regional Championship. That's the big victory here tonight. For Jenny Taff, Ricky Carmichael, and Jeff Emmick, I'm Ralph Shaheen. So long from Phoenix. We'll see you next week on FS1 from San Diego.
Get a grasp on reality.
I had to adapt and change very rapidly.
I had to learn how to drive with my hands. Yeah, that was interesting. I was a dancer. I don't see walking the way I walk any different than doing a dance. It just looks different. It's a different dance.
You see me have an off day, it doesn't take away from who I am.
A symptom may cause you not to be able to do that anymore. And at one point, I was able to do any of those.
But I would exercise every day.
Since I've been cycling, that's definitely helped my walking.
To make a lot of changes. My life and just adapt to it.
I'm going to acknowledge its presence. I'm not going to discount it, but at the same time, I'm going to try my best to not let it stop me.
It's a fantastic opportunity to be working together on a common goal of carrying MS, and sharing is the key.
New ideas and new energy, and with the girls we hire, it comes
out bigger and better. A lot of work and a lot of time goes into it, so the product is excellent. The girls just, they brought some really sexy suits, and everybody looks so different and unique and like glamorous and hot, like chic. Every girl is so cool, and they're honestly like the sweetest girls I've ever met. Just a lot of fun and laughter and great energy, because it's the beach. How can you be sad at the beach? I couldn't have asked for a better office day. The whole calendar is, I think it's just gonna knock everybody's socks off. Game time.
I hate to do that.
Here we are shooting in San Pedro this year, which is a location that we've never been to before.
It's a new terrain. It's a new landscape for Brandon to work with. A lot of different great sceneries and rocks that play differently. Right when I saw the rocks and I saw the waves crashing over them, and I was like, I just want to be aerial and get on my rock and be a mermaid. It's a really, really cool spot. A lot of shallow water. We've actually been able to put a lot of people in the water today.
So we have literally like 100 yards of only about 1 to 10 feet deep water that we can use.
Shit.
The other great thing about this location is that the waves break on the rocks.
Oh,
so
God.
When the water comes in, it's very calm, it's very still, and that allows us to get a lot better shots than we have at previous locations where the water has been a little bit treacherous.
So being here is incredibly exciting for the girls. I mean, beautiful tide pools that we've seen so far. We have beautiful, like, desert mountains behind us.
Just so we can get images that invoke that California bikini lifestyle.
Shitting me.
People. And me personally, I could talk to a wall for 3 hours if I wanted to, like that. It's very important that we're giving back to the community, and we also get to work in this fun environment, so it's a win-win. What I really wish more than anything is that
fans could
really talk to them and get to talk to them even more, to get to know them beyond just saying hi at a game, because you will find the script is amazing. And hearts of gold, and they're gorgeous and funny, and everyone has their own unique personality.
You gotta be kidding
me. And I can't
me.
Wait to spend, you know, all season with them. Really takes a small army, no joke, to put this project together. Everything from a crew of probably 50 to 60 of us out here today on the video side, the still photo side, the hair and makeup glam squad, as we call them. We had the ultimate pampering session this morning.
Third time sitting in this makeup chair, but I still feel like a rock star. This doesn't get old at all.
I was definitely a little nervous coming in this morning because I am a rookie.
She is a calming force today. I love having her next to me today. She's an awesome veteran. When I saw that she was scheduled to shoot with me, I was like, oh my God, thank God.
It was just amazing, like looking in the mirror and being like, that's me? Like, what have I been doing all this time?
I gave the balls and kissed it. 13.
Shooting here, but you know, we're at the games and we sell them ourselves, and then we actually get to work the
Christmas with the troops. We are there at CHLA visiting Children's Hospital, and we visit Ronald McDonald's house. We get to see all these different places where the money goes, and it's so rewarding at the end.
I first heard about the ICE crew when I was out at an event for charity, and I first heard about King's Care. And I thought, how cool is that? Not only are we coming together as a team, but we're giving back to the community. And you know how fun as it's been today? At the end of the day, we're going to raise a lot of money. And that is my favorite thing about the LA Kings. I'm really looking forward to doing some good in the community. And when it all goes to charity, I mean, it's just so much bigger than this. It's not just girls in swimsuits.
Gotta hit it, man.
I got to be a part of that. I mean, that really means something.
There.
Knowing that those benefits go towards the King's Care Foundation, I think has helped the success year after year. And we're hoping for more success and more calendar sales this year.
And that we're a part of something so large. We raise so much money together every year. It's extremely humbling and absolutely amazing.
This year is the first time that we've got more rookies than we have veterans, and the rookies today have really brought it.
Peanut is down there killing it right now. I'm telling you, the rookies this year are smoking. Kings fans are in for such a treat.
At Supercuts, we pay attention to every detail, so you'll feel sharp, clean, and ready to go. Lowe's presents How to Put Your Foot in Your Mouth.
Man, I wish my yard looked like yours. Hey, the grass is always greener on the other side of the... Sorry.
Now get 20% off Stay Green Fertilizer at Lowe's.
Okay, what do you do now?
This is all your first time ever doing anything like this before? It's going to be very fun. I'm really easy to work with, and I'll work with you girls, and I'll give you lots of feedback on what you need to be doing. Trust in what I'm telling you and what I'm having you do, because it's a swimsuit calendar, and it needs to be a connection with the viewer. Keep that in mind, right?
Each girl to bring her best, and that's where Brandon comes in and why he's so critical to this entire process. So whether your experience or not, it doesn't matter, because he adjusts to work with each person individually.
We have a lot of new faces this year, so that's kind of a challenge to work with people that haven't been shot before. So we're always trying to bring each girl out of their shell and feel beautiful.
It's definitely important to feel sexy during the shoot. I mean, you don't want to be out there all nervous and like cowering down, but he really gets you in that comfort zone and makes you feel just like you're a star.
And that's huge. If you don't feel like you look sexy, you will not take a sexy picture.
Brandon gave me a pep talk, and he's like, you'll be fine, just relax, and you'll look good. Obviously, if you didn't look good, you wouldn't be here, and I'm like, duh. Brandon is an absolute crack up. He gets all into the poses as well. It's just the funniest thing ever.
Try both hands across the wrist on top of the head. Yes, kick the hips from side to side. Good.
So it really is a really cool, interesting dynamic this year, because it's the first time that we've got more rookies than we have veterans. Super supportive with helping all the rookies out that had no idea what we're doing. They had one of the other girls kind of watch me to learn how I was posing and what I was doing. I've never gone into a group setting like this where everyone is so welcoming, and I do think this calendar will be top-notch. The veterans really set the tone with teamwork and camaraderie. So as the rookies coming in, know the drill. Like, you know, this is a team and we work together.
Peanut is down there killing it right now. Rookies this year are smoking. Kings fans are in for such a treat.
I hope I rocked it just as well as they did. The girls are a really positive group that all really work together really well, and the rookies today have really brought it. In order to be ready for the photo shoot, there's a
the gym every day. I spend a couple hours there, watch my Netflix. Yeah, I get through all my shows on Netflix at the gym. I don't think I could have done as well as I think I felt if I didn't watch Tegan. And I try to steal, you know, her confidence with the shoot. And I wasn't afraid to get all wet, jump in the rocks a little bit, lay on the rocks. I got a little beat up on the knees, but it was worth it because I think we got some pretty good shots. So I went right into the water, little sea anemones everywhere. And then I was just kind of posed up on the rocks and the waves are coming over me. So I think it'll make a really good photo.
It was a lot different going from the quiet land scenery to the ocean, but it was a lot of fun. I definitely feel at home in the water. Well, I spent 4 years in the Coast Guard, and it was just a great, amazing experience for me. To be able to share the next journey with the Kings is just an honor, too. But this is definitely a very different day at the beach, and it's just been gorgeous. You can't ask for better than this.
I am beyond honored to be shooting today. It's actually my birthday. To be here today.
I don't like any of this right now.
My office on my birthday, I mean, you can't beat that. So this is the best birthday present ever. And it was amazing, and the lighting was gorgeous, and I just can't wait to see the pictures.
3, 2, 1. Good. 3, 2, 1. Gorgeous. Great. Good, good.
I was on top of a rock and it was a lot of balancing. It was good. So thankful and blessed that I was given this opportunity to be able to shoot the King's Calendar. And one thing that led me to try out was definitely have such a strong passion for hockey and for the Kings that I just looked out at those girls on the ice and I was like, I want to be there. I want to be on that ice. And I love being a part of it. Good morning! I'm officially now too! Just got here, very excited. It's awesome. It is day 2 of the calendar shoot and we are back in Malibu, California at Westford Beach Point Doom, which is a very familiar location. At the end of the shoot in San Pedro, I was really excited at the end of yesterday, heading in today, because we had such great shots. What I've seen so far on day 1 was great. I was following it on Twitter.
Damn it.
Keeping up with all the girls, and they all look beautiful in their suits this year. So coming out here day 2, I mean, we have a great team of stylists, we have a great photographer. These 2 days are so important. The girls, the weather, the location, everything goes into it.
You gotta be kidding me.
We're in Malibu right now, so there's not a ton of people. There's beautiful scenery. I actually grew up coming here, and it's so cool to be like where I grew up, where I spent countless days at the beach, and then we're shooting right here. And we get to shoot at sunset, so we're super stoked. It's gonna be so much fun.
God, I knew I had to hit it a little harder. It's dead straight.
Looking great, Megan.
Each year we come to Malibu, the ocean's beautiful.
Point Doom's obviously beautiful, but let's be honest, is anyone really looking at the background?
Damn it.